warriors together. I am, you are, we all are. It's what we were saying before. It shows the testing, and we have the best tests in the world. But what happens in between when you get tested and just a couple of days later? So in this case, there were a number of days missed, and it was a long weekend and things, and so you never know. But we both tested in a negative fashion, I guess you would call it.
So we just wanted to turn that around. That was President Trump reacting to his valet at the White House testing positive. Valet, part of this elite military unit, works very closely in the West Wing. You heard the president say he tested negative and that he will be tested every day now. So let me bring in our senior medical correspondent, Elizabeth Cohen, and our chief political analyst, Gloria Borger. And Elizabeth, that was news to me that he said he will now be tested every single day.
Right, exactly. And so they're testing every single day now, but they weren't then. So how long, this gentleman who has now tested positive, how long was he in the White House when he might have been infectious? It sounds like we may never know. But, you know, eventually this becomes sort of a game of numbers. There are people who work in the White House who go home every day. They go home to family members who might be infected. This virus is circulating, and then they come into the White House. Even if you test them every day, which is certainly more of a sure thing than every week, you can still miss people. These tests are not perfect. As a matter of fact, there have been complaints that these tests have more false negatives than many other tests do. So you are going to miss people. It becomes then a huge question mark why they're not wearing masks in the White House and why President Trump continues to say, let's open up the country, when here he has an example in his very own office of someone who came in and had COVID and people didn't know.
No, every single